Hey everyone, welcome to Speedway Motors Tech Talk. I'm Joe, and today Josh is here to talk to us about a new product.
Yeah, it's our new EFI AN6 filter and regulator. It's basically a copy of what the Corvettes had on them for their filter and regulator in their system, a returnless style system, meaning that it didn't have a return all the way up at the motor on the fuel log. So this one will run a real short return back to the tank here so you don't waste a lot of hose. Been selling these real well for a lot of years, regulated to 58 PSI, but we were having to switch them over with those adapter AN fittings from the original GM Quick Connect snap together lines.
And we're standing here under our yellow truck. We're about to install this new one, and we're replacing the old one, which is, this is an example of how they used to be with the adapter. You know, here's your GM plastic Quick Connect, and then this is this adapter fitting to go out to a number 6 male. And this just cleans it right up, takes a potential leak point out by removing the adapter, and should just plug right in place.
So we're just gonna put this back up in the spot of our old filter here, same line, same lengths and everything, so should mount right back up and fire back up here.
And you can see where we are on the truck. We installed this towards the rear. You know, that's the beauty of this thing, is that your return basically just has to go from here to here rather than all the way up from the fuel rail back to the tank. You know, the cool thing about it too is when you talk about tidy fittings and eliminating leak points, this has a regulator in it also. So it's pre-regulated to 58 PSI, which is perfect for LS swaps. And that way you don't have a separate filter, separate regulator, you know, and all of those fittings to go along with it and all that expense.
There is no hex on the filter for tightening against with our AN fitting, but I know that we tested a lot of these when we got our first samples made. And you know, you about had to have a breaker bar on them to get the the fitting to actually twist on here.
So you just tighten the fitting, the end of the fitting into the, without holding it.
Right, and I mean, as with any fuel system fitting, to me, I get them pretty snug and then check for leaks, you know,
and then
snug them up a little more rather than just putting them, you know, stupid tight right away, because that's a good way to not get reused fittings and stretch fittings and do stupid things, pull threads.
All right, we're done. You know, that looks a lot better without all the extra fittings on it.
Yeah, a little cleaner, less places to leak. It mounted right back up where the old one was. Easy swap, probably took us 5 minutes total, so.
Now we'll lower it, we'll prime the system and check for leaks, and then we should be good. All right, we're done. That was maybe the easiest thing we've ever done back here.
Yeah, meant to be a straight swap for that old piece with the adapter fitting, so. Not really that elaborate of a piece, but a much needed piece and simplified, made exactly for the LS swap market rather than a GM piece with adapters and whatnot. Just kind of highlighting that Speedway covers everything soup to nuts on these cars and trucks. When you want to adapt a new LS motor into an older chassis, whether it's oil pans, you know, headers, fuel system, front drive, anything like that. So we've got a really complete selection to be able to do this for these old trucks. So.
Yeah, and some people are still scared, you know, an LS is some kind of a mystery. Parts like this take the mystery out of it. All right, thank you, Josh, and thanks to everybody for watching.